It's day 778 of the pandemic, and the cracks are beginning to show. Before the pandemic, I would FaceTime my parents once a week on a Sunday. We'd natter a little bit about what we've been up to, a bit of travel, some nice restaurants, and a bit of gossip. Now, I'm having to have group chats with my entire family on an almost daily basis. Chats that seem to go on forever, where we'll sit there blinking slowly, updating each other on the tedium of our post-COVID lives, trapped in our squares on the screen, like players in a budget game show, looking up each other's nostrils because of the collective lack of effort our family has put into finding flattering camera angles. "So, what have you been up to today?" Mum asks me. I went to the supermarket. "All by yourself?" "Yes, Mum, all by myself." "Oh, lovely," coos Mum, in the same tone of envy as if I'd announced I'd just booked 2 weeks in the Maldives. "You've got a bogey, Dad."
"Where?"
"Where? What do you mean, where?" "It's up your nose, where you've kindly given me an unrivaled view of your sinuses."
"Is it gone?"
Nope.
"No?"
"Nope."
"No?"
"Nope."
"No?"
"Nope."
"No?"
"Nope."
"No?"
"Yeah, it's gone now." We all sit in silence for a while, the excitement of Dad's bogey having depleted all of our natural energy reserves. He's halfway out of his chair when the screen freezes. "You frozen, Mum?" "Hey, maybe we should call it a day and chat tomorrow."
"But we've only just begun, darling, and it's Mother's Day."
Mum insists. "Okay. What about you? Anything interesting happened since yesterday?"
"Well,"
begins Mum, and for a moment my heartbeat quickens in anticipation of a suitable highlight with which to end the call.
"We went to the supermarket."
"Right."
"And..."
"This sounds promising."
"Go on,"
I encourage her.
"And the cashier at the checkout was wearing one of those visor things that make you look like you're in space."
"Uh-huh."
"So I say, supervisor, and you'll never guess what she did next."
"Called her supervisor?"
"She called her supervisor."
Mum delivers her punchline before a strange slurpy sound tortures my ears.
"Oh!
Mum, what is it?"
"Ooh! It's your father!" "Ooh!"
Mum gags.
"He just teabagged me."
"What?"
"He just teabagged me."
"He did what?"
"He just teabagged me."
"Ugh!" Mum shrieks and spits.
"Ugh!"
"Sorry, Mum, you're breaking up. It sounds like you just said..."
"It's your father. He just teabagged me."
"What?" I study the frozen screen through a horrific new lens. Dad crouched over his chair, his mouth slightly open, talking to Mum. Mum turns to face him. Her face inches from his...
"He didn't." "He did, darling. It's disgusting. I hate it when men do that, don't you?"
"So lazy."
"Sorry, Mum, can you explain exactly how this happened?"
"It's your father. He just gave me a cup of tea and he left the bag in. I took a sip and got the bag."
"It's revolting."
"For crying out loud, Mum. That's not what teabagging is. Good job I wasn't driving. I'd have crashed the car."
"Why, what do you call teabagging?"
It's... It's when somebody gives you a cup of tea and you take a sip and find the bags still left in. I finish lamely.
My darling, that's exactly what I said. Anything else?
Last night I watched Love Actually and I actually cried at the end.
That doesn't sound like you, darling.
God, I miss airports.
Okay, must fly.
Trills Mum, rubbing salt in my wound.
I've got some ironing that needs doing. Tell you all about it tomorrow.
Can't wait.